Hi everyone, it's Lisa here to show you a craft, or actually this is more of an art form that you can do at home. There is no kit available for this one, and that's okay because I don't know that you're going to need a kit. You should have supplies or almost all of your supplies at home. Today's art project or craft is this bleach image stained t-shirt. And what I have simply done is I've taken a t-shirt. In this case, it's a hoodie. I've just bought this. I intend to give this to my granddaughter. But I have used bleach and an image to actually form this little piece of art on the front. So before we get started with our description on how we're going to do this, let's look at the supplies that we're going to need. Obviously, you're going to need a shirt. Now, the black is going to stain, bleach stain to a gray and a little bit of pink. Now that kind of looks brown probably from where you were viewing this on with a camera, but that is a little bit of a pink stain around there. Now if I used a red or a gray, obviously we know that the bleach is going to act just a little bit differently, but we do need a t-shirt for this. Other things that you might need or will need for this is Clorox bleach or any of your bleaches. You're going to need a fine spray bottle. So I would double, when I first bought this spray bottle, I had to adjust the nozzle to make sure it was on a fine mist spray. So play around with it before you get started on your actual project. Other things that you might need or will need, excuse me, are images. Now, how do you get your image? If you have a Cricut machine, these are easy to form with your Cricut and your vinyl. And so you could do that. I have simply bought, for the t-shirt that I just displayed to you, these felt stickers. And these are great because you can simply just take the backing off of them, stick those or place those on your shirt, and you're ready to go. I also have stars, and we're going to use the stars today on the demonstration, and these are the same thing. They are foam stars that are stickers, so these are easy to place on your t-shirt. You can also use contact paper, just contact drawer liner paper. So if you have some of that at the house, you can easily cut out your shapes. That has a backing that can be pulled off, and those can be placed on your t-shirt. Now, one thing I did not try, but I think this will actually work. These are heart-shaped doilies. These are paper doilies. And what I've done is I have pulled four of them, and I would probably use three or four of those if I were going to use those as my image. So in a nutshell, you're going to need an image. It can be the stars. It could be your doily. It could be hearts. It could be shamrocks. If you work on your Cricut, it could be a matter of anything. So that's your basic supplies. Oh, sorry, I forgot to tell you. You're going to need something to protect your surface. I'm using a trash bag here. And I'm also going to need something on the inside of my t-shirt so that the bleach does not run through to the back of the garment itself. And what I did was I actually folded. It's recommended that you use a cardboard if you have it. I did not have a cardboard. Although I think you could use a file folder, of which I do have. But today what I'm going to be using is a second piece of, or a second garbage bag. And that's what I'm going to put up in the center of that in just a moment, and I'll show you how to do that. So your essential supplies, again, you'll need some trash bags to protect your surface. You'll need something that's going to go up inside of your t-shirt to keep it from bleeding into the back of the t-shirt. You'll need your image, you'll need your bleach, and you're going to need a spray bottle. Very simple. Now, the one that I have put together to show you today is an exact replica of the other one. It is actually the same garment. And what I'm doing is I have folded my trash bag and I've put it up through the center all the way to the top. I'm actually going to pull that up just a little bit to make sure that I've got my surface underneath completely covered. I'm going to probably, in this case, I'm probably going to flip my hood under, and I'm going to put my sleeves out to the side there. I have taken two sizes of my stars, and I have placed those in the center. Peeled the back off of them, placed them where I wanted them. Now, to get your mixture of bleach, all I simply did was run half water, half Clorox bleach. And I have swirled that together, making sure it's mixed up completely. You can use gloves for this if you'd like. I do not use gloves. I think when I did my demonstration, I did fine with that. I wasn't able to get it on my hands or on any of the other surfaces. And the key to that, I think, is making sure that you have a good spray bottle. So simply all you do is you spray. You spray as much or as little as you want. Obviously, the more you spray, the lighter the surface around your image is going to become. And so we're going to get started on that. Very, very simple. Now I'm spraying over here just a little bit. And you're going to see almost an immediate transformation here. Now I'm going to get a paper towel. And any of the places that were large, like there was a drop of it, I'm going to just dab. Now you can already see the transformation taking place. And you'll notice it's turning a little bit of a pinkish color right now. And the more it dries, the lighter it will become. And it's at this point where you can decide whether you want it lighter by putting more bleach or whether you just want to leave it as it is. Now, I kind of like that look. I feel like it's going to bleach out just a little bit more as it starts to dry. I can see just a few dots here where it got a little crazy, but I'm okay with that. This is going to turn out really cute, I'm pretty sure. So I'm going to go ahead. Now I need to let this dry, but I want to show you the image itself just by pulling it off. And there's my first star. Now I'm going to leave those on there for just a few minutes, and let me explain just a couple of things. You probably want this to dry completely before you pull your images off. The only reason I pulled the image off is that I wanted you to see what a transformation that is and how quickly that occurred. Again, the more you spray, the whiter your surface will become. I also want you to note that it is not a perfect little star. I truly believe by using a Cricut or by using something that is a little bit more exact, for instance, your contact paper, that you'll get a crisper image by using those two products. But I'm pretty happy with that. As a matter of fact, I think my granddaughter is really going to like this. But we're going to let that dry just a little bit more. And again, don't forget to make sure you've got that surface between the top and bottom layer. And that way it doesn't bleed through to the other side. Now it will take a while for this to dry, but I'm going to go ahead and pull the other images off so that you can see. Once this is finished and completely dry on its own, we are going to wash this on a normal cycle, whatever you would normally wash this. I don't think there's any need to wash it by itself. But if you choose to do that for fear that any of the bleach might get on your other clothing in your laundry, I totally understand that. But look how easy that was to get that image transferred to this t-shirt. This is the DIY bleach image t-shirt. It's pretty much no fail. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing it because I like the simple tasks or simple projects. Just remember to give it a good washing, and this is ready to wear. It should be fine. It should be a great little t-shirt that my granddaughter is going to get a lot of use out of. I hope you've enjoyed this craft. Keep in mind things that you've got at home, how you can benefit from just using shirts that you have at home, maybe even a stained t-shirt. This would be great to put a decal or an image on there and bleach out that part that has been stained. So think about the t-shirts that you already have at home. You don't necessarily need to buy a new one for this. I hope you've enjoyed this project. Think about trying it at home. Post it on our Facebook page if you like it and you've done a great job with it. And keep crafting, friends.